Ahoy, this is Zdenka. One of the mistakes new photographers make is composition. Poor framing, not emphasizing the object in the photos enough, and not really telling the story. Yeah, well, it's more like a mixture of mistakes. Well, I really thought that today I should be talking about how I process my thoughts, what I'm thinking in my head, how I'm getting there to take the shot, what my process really is of getting the shots. And hopefully, since I really want to help you out, you will open up your mind and your eyes and start seeing it as well. For the new faces, welcome. My name is Zdenka Darla. I work as a photographer since 2007. I make tutorials, tech reviews, and creative camera challenges. So if that's something you are interested in, consider hitting the subscribe button. When I was 15 years old, I was obsessed with photos in fashion magazines particularly. I had to go through all the magazines, flip all those pages, look at all those photos, never read any article. I just wanted to see more photos, more and more and more. And then I was 16 and I started doing modeling, and throughout my modeling years, I was still obsessed with the photos, but I wanted to have them in my portfolio. I always saw some photo in a fashion magazine, I wanted to have that style. But sometimes it was quite challenging to find the right photographer which could actually do that for me. And at the age of 27, 28, I transitioned from modeling to photography. And that's when I finally was happy, because I could capture all those photos I always wanted to have. I never went to school, I never studied photography, I literally borrowed the camera from my friend for the weekend. I did my first shoot with a model, and that shoot landed me my first magazine cover. Now, I'm not saying this to show off whatsoever. What I am saying is that there is a group of people which have that natural eye in them. They are born with it, they are very lucky, they just grab the tool and they go. Then there is a group of people which they have it in them too, but they need that little push, that little just go and start seeing it. And then there is the third group of people which unfortunately will never see it. When I'm holding a camera, when I'm holding any camera, and I'm standing, for example, on the street, I'm looking around, I'm trying to find an object to take photos of. If I see people, and there is a group of people, maybe even three or four, there's the one person which stands out. And it can be because it's strange person looking, or great person looking, or beautiful, strange, goofy, something like that, something which really catches my attention. There's always something about that one person which stands out. The same thing happens when I'm shooting weddings. When I see a group of people, there's one person which will stand out, and that will be the focus of my image. If I'm taking a portrait of a person, I usually very quickly look at the person and immediately I see one thing which catches my attention. Maybe beautiful eyes, full lips, or just cheek bones, you know, structure of the face. Something which really catches my attention and stands out on that person. If there is a scene like a street or a city or landscape or anything like that, I always pick one object as well, whether it's a window, balcony, doors, building, corner, just a nice street, leading lines. It's usually the one thing which will catch my eye. I rarely take photo of a clutter. If you try to take photo of everything, it will be very messy and it's not gonna be that eye-catching, stand-out photo. Thank you. Try this. Grab a few objects in your house and put them on a table. Kind of leave it as a group. Take photo of it, snap it. Now look at the photo and you will see it's just a, you know, group of objects together. Now take one object which you like the most for whatever reason, pull it much closer to you. Focus on that object, keep the rest kind of in a background, far back, a little bit blurred out. Take the photo. Now look at the photo and you will see right away that it's much stronger, much more eye-catching photo. It is the best to try to avoid taking photos of a clutter. You probably heard about the rule of thirds. They always say that the beginners are placing the object usually in the center of the image, but they should be using a rule of thirds, kind of moving it a little bit more to the side. Well, not always. Rules are to be broken, and I break them a lot of times. I place the main focus of the image lots in the center. But I also place the main focus of the image lots on the side. If I'm taking photos of a models, you know, fashion or portraits or swimwear, glamour, then obviously most of the time I place them in a center. But if I'm taking photos on the street or at the weddings, or if I'm doing landscape or something like that, and if it is more like an empty, large scene and I have the object in the center, I kind of find that I'm missing something, or if it's not interesting or there's some interesting curve, then yes, I place it more to the side to make it more interesting for sure. I like to take a lot of simple, plain photos of an object, but then to develop the set to more interesting shots, to have it like a full interesting set, I like to look for natural framing of the photos. And I'm not talking about the digital framing or the artificial framing of the photos. I'm talking about the natural framing. It can be from one side, both sides, all sides, from the top, from the bottom. If I'm taking a photo, for example, of a person in a group of people, one person talking, how about including maybe the shot of blurred shoulders of those other people? Those shoulders are creating a frame to the main object. Window can be a frame, door can be a frame, building can be a frame, a lot of trees in the background can be a frame. The frame can be in the foreground and background as well. I love to shoot through stuff. So I love to shoot through branches, through leaves. At the wedding, I like to shoot through the glasses. Just make it more interesting. The blurry stuff in the front can frame the object very nicely in the back. If you are taking photos of a lake, sea, or nature, big landscape, make sure the horizon is really nice and straight. Don't have it like this or this. It's very difficult to fix it in post. I love to use zoom lens on my camera. I love to zoom in and out, and I love to frame and crop the object, the photo, right away in my camera, because I'm simply too lazy to spend all that time editing on the computer. Yeah, I'm too lazy. So whether you have a zoom lens or you have a prime lens, try to frame it right away in your camera. I've seen many photos where the main focus of the image, the main object, is way too far or way too close. Frame it correctly. Fill out the space. Have it balanced and symmetrical. If I'm taking a photo of a person, I don't cut off the top of the head. I leave a little bit space on the top, a little space on the bottom, make it very nice and symmetrical, well balanced. If you have zoom lens, then zoom in or zoom out. If you have a prime lens, then, you know, get up on your feet and move, get closer or back up. If I'm taking a photo of a family, they all need to be nice and sharp. If I am taking a photo of a landscape, city, or with just a large scene, that it would be nicer if everything will be sharp. If I am taking a photo of a person in a crowd and I want the person to stand out, I'm gonna use lower aperture or lower f-stop so the person is nice, sharp, and everything else is blurry. It would be much stronger image, especially if I'm trying to capture an emotion. I always try to think about the aperture first before I move on to setting up the shutter speed. I usually don't settle just for one angle. I take the photo from the front And then I start moving. I go a little bit to the right and a little bit to the left, a little bit to the top and a little bit to the bottom. And then I move even more and I just follow the object and I walk around and I see if there is something more interesting I can see in the photo. Usually there is definitely better angle. So don't settle just for one angle. Move around. I usually do that a lot during the wedding. You'll see me moving all the time, but not during the ceremony. There's always better angle from different side, but even slight tiny move can make a huge difference. When I was starting out in photography, I used to get very obsessed taking that one photo. I was taking the photo all the time. I just wanted to capture it, whatever was in my head. I used to get so frustrated when it didn't go the way I wanted. I was wasting so much time. I learned not to plan the specific photo. I learned to go with the flow, let the scene to evolve on its own. If I'm working with a new model, I let them pose for about 10 minutes on their own, see how they are moving, what their body structure is, before I start steering them the way I want. If you're stuck on one thing, don't waste your time, move on. There were so many times when I was taking photos of a model and just something was missing. It was not it. I was not getting that top-notch photo. So I changed a few things. And sometimes I changed the whole wardrobe or even the whole scene. I changed everything. I am finding that the best results I ever got, most of the best results I ever got, are actually the unplanned, very spontaneous shoots. Those are always the best. I really hope you grabbed some info here and there from today's video. Hit the thumbs up button if you like today's video. Subscribe to all videos like these or future videos on this channel. If you have any questions, comments, or simply want to say hello or share your creative process, please do so in a comment section below. You know that I always read it all and I always respond. And I will see you, my friends, in the next video. Ciao, ahoy.